Hi, welcome to my channel. I'm Shamapti and my hair is alright, right? I think so. So today I have this list of the skincare products that I really love. Actually, I have started using these things very recently and I came to love these things. And I'm someone, if I love something or someone, I'm not afraid of telling it in front of the whole world. So here I am, professing my love for this skincare stuff. So I think, yeah, I have overhyped these things already. But know this, skincare is really subjective. So these products are working wonderfully for me, but this might not work for you. So do a patch test. And now let's start. At first, I have this Bioderma Atoderm cleansing oil. I have no idea why they are calling this a cleansing oil. This doesn't feel like a conventional cleansing oil or cleansing balm. It feels like a gel cleanser. I don't see how this is gonna work as a first cleanser, but it works very good as a second cleanser, and I'm loving this one. It creates moderate foam, it feels gentle on my skin, and it removes dark sunscreen and light makeup quite effectively. This is kinda expensive for 200 ml. We are paying 1200 something, but this is gonna last me for a long time. Like, I'm talking about 5 to 6 months, because all I need is just one pump. And this is not a morning cleanser for morning. I need something more creamy. This is gonna be for my evening skincare routine. And you can use this for your body as well, but I'm not gonna use this as body wash because it's too expensive for that for me. But overall, this is good. Now I'm gonna show you how I use this cleanser. First, I'm gonna wet my skin. Alright, so now I'm gonna go in with this cleanser. And you can see it has this very gel-like texture. And I love the texture. It feels so silicone-y and so slippery. It glides on my skin very well. And I'm gonna massage this on my skin for like 1 minute, and then I'm gonna wash it off. It creates moderate foam. It removes my sunscreen and dirt from my skin very well. For makeup, I don't use much makeup, but yeah, it is very effective in removing light makeup. But if you use eye makeup, then it won't be enough, I think, because it stings eyes a bit. So yeah, you're gonna need a separate cleanser to remove your eye makeup. For that, you can use micellar water as a first cleanser. After rinsing this off, my skin feels very good, clean but not dry, and I really love this as my evening cleanser. Overall, it is really good. And Bioderma has this another cleanser, their gel cleanser. This is good as well. This is cheaper than this one. It has decent ingredients as well and performs well, and it creates more foam than the other cleanser, and it can work for all skin types. This is, I mean, I like it, but I love this one. And they have marketed this for these two products for dry skin, but I can tell you it can work for all skin types. Okay, one thing, this Bioderma cleansing oil, the ingredients list that you'll find on Nykaa, that is not a genuine ingredients list, because there you'll see the fragrance comes way up in the ingredients list, but here I can see the fragrance is the last ingredient. It mostly has glycerin, then few gentle surfactants, texture enhancers, it has niacinamide, and yeah, overall good stuff. And if you want me to do a detailed review about these two products, let me know. I'm gonna do that. So next, what I have, I have one BHA toner, and this is my favorite chemical exfoliant ever. This BHA toner has very minimal ingredients list. It feels so light, the texture is so good, it feels non-sticky. My skin absorbs it really well. Then I use this twice or thrice in a week after cleansing at night, and let me tell you, it has become my most favorite chemical exfoliant. Textures gone, blackheads, wear, pores, okay. Everything is alright, life is good, my skin is good. It doesn't have salicylic acid as BHA. It has betaine salicylate. I think they have used 4% of betaine salicylate. It is said that you need 4% of betaine salicylate to be as efficient as 2% of salicylic acid. But salicylic acid has way more research backup, and betaine salicylate doesn't have that much research behind it. But whatever it is, this product has been working really well for my skin. I love it. My favorite used to be for BHA, this one from Minimalist, this 2% salicylic acid serum. But now, it is my number two. Now this is my number one. So what next? I have this old friend. So I'm supposed to talk about new skincare products that I have tried, but I'm talking about this because I used this long time back and I forgot about it, and I bought it again because I went to Via Naturals website. I bought their peptide moisturizer, which I have not tried out yet because I have been trying out few other moisturizers. I have ordered their eye serum as well. That eye serum is not good, it didn't work for me. But this one, on their 5% niacinamide serum, this is good, and I loved it then, I love it now, and I have been using this lately. I mostly use Niamax. It has 4% niacinamide, but these days I'm using this Via Naturals niacinamide serum, and this is very good. The texture is very light, but sometimes, you know, it gives me this very slight white foam kind of a thing on my skin. I don't know what is it. I really don't know. Not all the time, some of the time, but nothing too serious. It didn't give me any reaction or skin irritation, so I'm okay there. But yeah, that white foam kind of thing is there sometimes. But overall, I love this one, and I reviewed this long time back. If you want to know about the ingredients and details, I'm gonna leave the link of that video down below. So up next, I have another serum, and this is one soothing calming serum from Jumiso. It is their Centella and Cica. Centella and Cica was wrong with me. Sorry, Cica and Aloe. So it has 41% of Centella and 31% of aloe vera extract. This is good. My skin got irritated. I tried this one, it soothed my skin, and it has good ingredients. It has very long list of ingredients, but mostly it's made of, you know, Centella and Cica. They only have less than 1% of those extracts that they have used. They have used a lot of extracts. I'm gonna make a detailed video about this product, but this is good. Texture is love, very hydrating and soothing. It has niacinamide as well, and so far so good. But you're gonna have difficulty in getting this now because I think Beautyburn is not accepting new orders now for the lockdown. And yeah, it is not available anywhere, I think, in India except Beautyburn. So next, I have this ceramide moisturizer from Earth Rhythm. So this is very good moisturizer, you know. I mean, this is mainly for dry skin, but I think it will work for normal and dry skin. For oily skin, it might feel a little heavy, but as night cream, you can use it. The ingredients, they seemed very nice, and it has like six kinds of six kinds of ceramides. And I'm gonna review these products with Recoil ceramide cream, which I didn't like that much. I like this one more because of the texture and how it worked on my skin. But this pump thing, it sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. Now it's working, but sometimes it doesn't. So Earth Rhythm, they need to work on their packaging, you know, the dispenser and everything, because I ordered their hair gel, even that one, the pump was not working sometimes. So yeah, this is the issue I have. Overall, the moisturizer is very good. Doesn't feel sticky, feels soothing, moisturizing, and yeah, good stuff. So next, I have one night cream. This is from Cetaphil. This is their new bright skincare line. So yeah, I love this night cream. The ingredients are decent. It mostly has glycerin, niacinamide, few glycols. Then it has other like hyaluronic acid and panthenol kind of stuff. The texture is very, very good. It doesn't feel heavy on my skin. I have been trying out their day cream as well, but the day cream is kind of में इट मेक्स माई स्किन स्वीट सो मच फील्स कैन हैवी ऑन माई स्किन बट द नाइट क्रीम इज लव द टेक्सचर द फील ऑफ इट द परफॉर्मेंस एवरीथिंग इज वेरी वेरी गुड एंड ही आई एम गोना रिव्यू दिस थिंग इन डिटेल्स दे हैव ऑल्सो वन टोनर बट आई एम नॉट that much into toner so I didn't get the toner and they have their cleanser from this line I found that to be unnecessary so I didn't buy that they have one body lotion which I found to be very very expensive for a body lotion didn't get that I got these two products this night cream and another is that day cream but this night cream is very very good see I have used this quite a lot and I'm gonna buy this again And another night cream that I really really love that has changed my skin for better that is from Pure to their Sika sleeping pack that one is very good actually even there are other affordable options for moisturizers I have spoken about those things in my last video I'm going to leave the link down you might find that to be helpful so next I had this rose oil from Minimalist And I was not that sure about rose oil and when I started using this rose thing for like 7 days my skin was breaking out I was having this textures and bumps everywhere but then it settled down my skin is way better now and I really do like this rose oil I use this at night and I use just 3 drops of this product initially I was using 1 drop because I was really scared then I went to like 2 drops now 3 drops and I can see it is making my skin glow kinda and I prefer this over squalene actually I thought I'd never say this because squalene is my most favorite but now this is my most favorite I think and see I used rose oil long time back when I was in college I bought something from Amazon I even forgot the name of the brand so what I did I washed my face and I put rose oil directly on my skin My skin broke out like anything. So yeah, I didn't expect much from rosehip. But now what I do, I clean my skin, I use serums and stuff. Then I use moisturizer. Then as the last step, I use this rosehip oil. This is what I do. But be really careful with facial oils because there are people whose skin just cannot tolerate oil no matter what. So if your skin gets triggered by oils and you get fungal acne from oils, then avoid. This oil initially irritated my skin, but now it's good. It is very lightweight. I use this as the last step of my skincare at night and I don't use this during the daytime. Actually, I'm going to talk about rosehip oil in details very soon because I need to talk about saturated oil, unsaturated oil. These things are very important when I talk about rosehip oil. So yeah, wait for the video. You might find that to be helpful. So yeah, these were my 7 things and I have another thing as well but I don't know if I should introduce this thing to you or not this is from Parmas their coconut oil formula body oil I love the texture I hate the ingredients this is coconut oil body oil right but it has more fragrance than coconut oil and other oils I don't know why they had to do it the texture is so good it is so lightweight I can see that it is locking the moisture so well but when I see the ingredients list I'm like why more fragrance than coconut oil and other stuff so yeah this is I don't know what to say I really love the texture how it makes my skin feel but I'm highly skeptical because of the ingredients list so if you have any recommendation for lightweight body oil let me know
now you may ask me where is the sunscreen Shamapti okay so I'm making a different video a separate video about sunscreen is going to be up next month and that's all for now choose your skincare products really wisely do your own research
because what works for me might not work for you because skincare is really really subjective but I hope these products work for you if you choose to get these things and if you want more affordable option I have made few videos dedicated to affordable but good skincare stuff I'm gonna leave the link down below so yeah that's all for now I hope you found this to be helpful and yeah see you very soon and thank you so much for watching and yeah take care bye bye